Good day, my listeners. Today we are going to talk about ecotourism. I do hope you will get some useful information from today's lecture. Let's begin. The term ecotourism means responsible to travel to a natural areas, as well as it is about ensuring that your visit also has a positive impact on the local community. This is a neologism that appeared in the late 20th century, compounded from eco and tourism. Ecotourism is a form of tourism involving visiting fragile, pristine, and relatively undisturbed natural areas. It is to educate the traveler to provide funds for ecological conservation. Ecotourism is not only conscious of its impact on the natural environment, but it is also sensitive to the local economy. It means it builds environmental awareness, provides direct financial benefits for conservation, provides financial benefits and respects local culture. All of them mean ecotourism. It is one of the most ethical ways of traveling. It benefits the traveler, the local, and the nature. Here are some specific advantages of ecotourism. Let's talk about the benefits of them. It helps build cultural awareness by fostering respect for the place you travel to and the community you visit. What can you do to help the environment? Think very carefully. Caring for the environment means respect the nature, avoiding the waste to the nature. Say no to plastic bags. Educational experiences is a way to educate public about a certain location, also about the importance of caring for the environment. Learn the new skills and information from the childhood, as well as when we speak about the tourism, ecotourism education, that means we have to educate our tourists, our local tourists, to just take care about the nature. Of course, it will bring economic growth. People prefer beautiful places. People prefer to visit beautiful places. So, they attract many people. Nobody wants to go to disrupted or ruined places. So here, ecotourism plays a very important role in economic sphere in their life. Now, let's speak about natural heritage. So what is natural heritage? Look at the picture. Too beautiful. Looking at it, you may have some kind of peace in your soul. It refers to the sum of total elements of biodiversity, including flora and fauna, ecosystems, and geological structure. When we speak about ecotourism of Uzbekistan, we have to say the following. You see on the screen beautiful nature, mountains, fresh air. Now, the next slide coming will tell us much about ecotourism of Uzbekistan. Uzbekistan is a sunny country with diversity of climatic conditions. Warm winter, hot summer, sun-filled and blooming spring, bracing and blustery autumn. The seasons come with the perfect weather conditions. Deserts including Kızılkum, Aralkum, Istikhurt, mountains including Chimgan, Kanchik, and others are all in Uzbekistan. Uzbekistan is located between the rivers Amudarya and Sirdarya. The length of Amudarya and Sirdarya you can see on the screen. The Ravshan River is also very famous and has a much important role in the climate of Uzbekistan. There are also several mountain ranges of the Tian Shan and Pamir in Uzbekistan. And between the mountains, there are plains and valleys. Aral Sea, which is located between Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan, is a severe environmental disaster in Uzbekistan. It of course attracts many people to disastrous tourism. Uzbekistan is a land where the sun is shining almost the whole year round, the kingdom of dry, hot summer, warm winter, soft, honey autumn, and bright, blossom spring. Tashkent hosted an international conference on the development of ecotourism and environmental protection. And the conference members were different international organizations concerning tourism and the national company of Uzbek tourism. And all this conference, all the questions, various perspectives were discussed. The implementation of the strategy to the development of ecotourism were discussed. Uzbekistan has a large number of potential sites for the organization of towers, namely national parks and reserves. Protection of nature is very important, and the nature of Uzbekistan is protected by the government. When we speak about national parks of Uzbekistan, we can say the following. We can give the list of following parks, national parks of Uzbekistan. They are the following. So yeah, Chatkal, Muratinsky, Badai-Tugay, Zamin, Ugam-Chatkal, Ravshan, Zamin, and others. All of them are famous for their beauty, for its beauty, for its climate. Chatkal State Nature Reserve is a reserve in the Tashkent province of Uzbekistan, comprising about 570 square kilometers of mountain steppes, mountain forests, alpine meadows, river valleys. Zamin National Park is the oldest nature preserve in Uzbekistan, created in 1926. Very important information you can see on the screen. After my lectures, you can read carefully about the information dates about these places. Generally, ecotourism deals with interaction with biotic components of the natural environments. Ecotourism focuses on socially responsible travel, personal growth, and environmental sustainability. Now, let's talk about the International Ecotourism Society. From the screen, you can see from the name of the international organization, you can understand what kind of organization it is. The main or aim of this International Ecotourism Society is to preserve the nature in the world. Of course, they donate much money on the preservation of the ecotourism in different kind of countries. Ecotourism is often misinterpreted as any form of tourism that involves nature. Especially, it involves the people who guest to the beauty. Some people just protect the nature, saying they are eco-friendly. When we speak about ecotourism, we should mention about jungle tourism. Jungle tourism is spread in the areas where there are just forests, the organized traveling or just journey to the jungles. It is subcategory of adventure traveling. Adventure traveling, jungle tourism especially shows great exotics to people who come from different countries. Jungle tours have become a major component of green tourism in tropical destinations and are relatively recent phenomenon of Western international tourism. People prefer why to be in jungle they want to feel themselves with the nature, close with the nature. So ecotourism is one of the most important part of tourism. Here we advise you to just educate the children to keep the nature, for themselves, for our society, as well as for the guests who come to our country to see the beauty, of our country. The people prefer to see only the beauty, not ruined, not destroyed places. So that was all for today. Thank you very much for being with me. Thank you for your attention. I was very glad to give some information concerning to ecotourism. Thank you.